I was hoping you could both detail for me both the UNESCO and European Commission plans on education specifically in Haiti and any efforts that are going to be made in a concrete form in the near future in terms of either rebuilding schools, training teachers and so forth, getting education back and running.
Maybe I will start. In fact, the first three projects and the fresh appeal are in the education area. We do believe that UNESCO has a unique role to play. In fact, the Ministry of Education, it so happened that the Ministry of Education is functioning from our premises in Port-au-Prince, and I have strengthened our office there. We are also helping the cluster among the other agencies get coordinated efforts. Also, I have to say that the agenda of education I've been promoting since my visit in New York, when I met Mr. Ban Ki-moon, John Holmes, Helen Clark and others, with a message which was shared by them that efforts in re-establishing education system should not lag behind the humanitarian efforts because it just brings normalcy to the life. And I'm very happy that we shared also the same vision. Of course, I understand there are other sectors in the European Commission that are working, but we do believe that there is a huge agenda for the education there, and UNESCO will do its part.
In the area of humanitarian aid, our focus in Haiti is on providing shelter, food, medicines, and hospital services. At the same time, we all recognize that the reconstruction of Haiti has to start as soon as possible, and together with the Commissioner for Development, Commissioner Peebles, we have discussed how we can show in Haiti a really high quality linkage between relief and reconstruction and development. Also keeping in mind that the humanitarian efforts there will continue for years to come. We won't be able to get the country back to normal and actually even the normal before the disaster was required humanitarian aid. We will have to continue to provide humanitarian assistance. Where humanitarian aid directly touches on education is in two points. The first one is that helping people during and after a disaster is not just about feeding them, it's not just about housing them. It is also about their dignity within families. Kids are those who can actually bring the normalcy that Mrs. Bokova talked about, but also schools are a very natural way to provide nutrition to kids, to make sure that kids not only return to studies that are so critical for their lives, so their lives don't get shattered by whatever disaster hits, but also it is a way to make sure that kids are going to grow with enough food in their belly so their intellectual capabilities are built normally. And in this area, it has always been a tradition of humanitarian aid and development to go really hand in hand. We also have talked with Commissioner Peebles that in the case of Haiti, the Commission and the Union is taking, specifically the Commission, but also member states, a very strong interest in what we call non-humanitarian disaster relief. And in this case, this is 100 million euros that go primarily to restore the functioning of government institutions. And of course, the education institutions are part of this normal functioning. And there, we really work hand in hand. There is a process of needs assessment that brings, under the coordination of the UN, that brings development organizations and of course the Commission together. And there, the area of education is a very, very high priority because, again, this is what will bring normalcy and actually will give future to Haiti if we take care of the kids of Haiti today.